to. Call Carl. Tell him to gas up the jet.
When we finally got to check it out, the vote was unanimous.
A definite buy.
Buy.
Next stop, the supermarket. We think this stuff's gonna be big. We're not usually wrong about these things.
Minute Maid Premium. Bite into it.
Now, the meat is cooked. It's all beautiful in this pot. It's greatly reduced in size. You'd be quite shocked. Let me show you what one of the short ribs looks like. The meat is simmered for 2 hours. Quite a difference, wouldn't you say? But the meat is so tender, and I just can't wait to pull it off the bone. And the broth is reduced, and now it's time to add the vegetables. So we'll add first 10 leeks in little bunches with a string so that they don't fall apart while they cook. And next, our turnips, 8 baby turnips. And as you add these vegetables, raise the heat because you want to bring it back to a low boil, that smile. Add these 2 celery hearts. And we're adding now 16 small baby carrots, 16 red potatoes. These are quite small. And at the top of the entire pot, I'm going to add 1 Savoy cabbage that's been trimmed and cut into eighths. This is all going to simmer for approximately 20 minutes until the vegetables are tender. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer than that for the potatoes and the carrots. And we'll leave the haricots verts to cook 10 minutes before we're actually going to serve the pot-au-feu. Now slice a baguette into 1.5-inch slices and toast them on a baking sheet until they're golden brown. And I like to toast them in an oven of about approximately 375 degrees. Pot-au-feu is traditionally served with lots of lovely condiments. I first had this delicious dish out in Lake Tahoe at Susie Tompkins' house. Susie's a friend of mine, and she had us out there for a wonderful weekend of cross-country skiing. And what a treat it was to come in after a day in the woods to partake of a wonderful feast of pot-au-feu and all the accompaniments and some really good red wine. And now toast these. I'd like to show you what the marrow bones look like. You can see that the water has turned a little bit of a color, and the marrow itself, still held very nicely in place, has become sort of translucent. You can see, almost see through it. That's exactly what you want without losing the marrow bones. Now this can be warmed. I'm going to just gently warm this on top of the stove. Don't overcook it though. You don't want to lose your marrow. And now for 10 minutes, I will cook a pound of the haricots verts, and then we'll be ready to serve our beautiful pot-au-feu.
Really?
Really.
Really?
Really.
Really?
Really.
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 Really?
Really.
Really?
Really.
Really?
Really.
Really.
People have been pre-washing their dishes for so long.
Really.
It's gonna take some getting used to the new Maytag Jet Clean Dishwasher. It has twice the number of powerful cleaning jets as any other dishwasher. So chances are you won't have to wash your dishes before you wash your dishes. Maytag Performance. You can depend on it.
Really?
Really.
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 There are those among us with very simple tastes. They only want the best. And for them, there's Fancy Feast Gourmet Cat Food. Exceptionally moist and delicious. Fancy Feast. Good taste is easy to recognize.
34 boys,
3 bathrooms. And a new Glade Spin Fresh in every one. Because it not only keeps the bathroom fresh continuously, Glade Spin Fresh delivers an extra burst of freshness with every spin.
Refillable Spin Fresh. Fresh from Glade.
Next, all new Rosie.
Big shot.
From the new movie, The Newton Boys, it's Matthew McConaughey, author Anne Rice, and Jimmy Ray performs.
Isn't that fun?
Plus, coming soon, Melanie Griffith, Dennis Hopper, David Alan Greer, and Lauren Holly.
Enjoyable to me.
Plus, the music of Jody Watley, Garth Brooks, and Dolly Parton.
It's going to be a great month. We're talking about it all month.
All new shows, all month long, on The Rosie O'Donnell Show.
Monday at 4 p.m. on NBC 33.
Hi, this is Uncle Sam. He's about to send you a big tax refund check. This guy sells stereo equipment. He wants your refund check. This guy, too, he sells hair pieces. Now, if you're driving without auto insurance, you'd better call these guys. Or you might have an unpleasant meeting with this guy. Or even this guy. So call these guys today, and you won't have to rely on this guy.
Safe auto.
My parents are on my back.
Do something.
I'm in the guidance counselor's office.
Daisy.
Everyone wants me to go to college.
Hey, get off my back!
All I got is a part-time job. I want to go to college, but all I got is nothing. Then I found out about Project Learn MS. The MS Association gets high school and college students to write an essay on multiple sclerosis and have the chance to win a total of $16,000 in scholarships. Now I can go to college. To register for Project Learn MS, call 1-800-LEARN-MS.
The important thing about the vegetables is to make sure that each and every vegetable is tender. The haricots verts are still a nice bright green. And what I'm going to do is just start removing first the vegetables, arranging them on our big serving platters. I'd like to have one platter for the vegetables and one platter for the meat. And take out your sections of cabbage. Every single bit of this meal is delicious. Take out each vegetable, and then we're going to remove some of the broth to the tureen. This is a very pretty white tureen. And the broth is going to need a little bit of seasoning. We have to remove most of it so that we can get the meat out of the pot. So here's our broth, which we will keep steaming hot in the tureen. I'm using big white dinner plates to serve the pot-au-feu. Potatoes look good. The hearts of celery look good. Our leek packets actually cooked very well. Here they are right here. You can untie them if you like. And this is a feast. You can see how much food there is here. And we still haven't gotten down to the meat. And now very carefully extract the chicken. I don't want it to fall apart, but if it does, it's okay. We're going to cut it up anyway. Didn't fall apart. I'm looking for that brisket. I can't imagine where it went. But here's a short rib. More leeks. Another short rib. Found the brisket. I'm going to put this right here. And now I'm going to slice first the brisket. Now, brisket is tricky. You have to slice it against the grain. And you have to look for the grain. You can see it here. It's all this way. So you want to go opposite the grain. This is slicing just wonderfully. You can slice everything, or if you think there's going to be some leftovers, you can just leave a big hunk of the meat unsliced. Now the short ribs, they too should be cut up into smaller serving pieces. You can actually put the bones on the plate, but it's nice to, again, cut this meat up into smaller serving pieces. And just proceed to arrange the platter any way you like. And the chicken is held together amazingly well, having been cooked for 2 hours in that broth. Here we have a nice drumstick. Now, if you think that everything's just falling apart here, the whole object of a pot-au-feu is that things have been cooked together, simmered slowly, and everything is extremely tender and succulent. That's the way this dish is supposed to be. If we want to take off the breast, cut it right down the breastbone, and this is perfect. Oh, it's so good. So the meat comes off in a big chunk. Don't forget the marrow bones. These look so pretty. There's something for everyone. Chicken, beef, marrow bones, and all kinds of vegetables. Pot-au-feu is truly an art and is best savored with incredible accompaniments. I'll show you over on our buffet table. There's Dijon mustard, cornichon, which are little sour French gherkins, Kalamata olives, freshly grated horseradish, coarse salt baguette toast. And the last part of the meal, the vegetables. I love how it looks. I love how it tastes. It's a great meal. And as you can see, it's all made in one big pot.
Don't! That's bad luck.
We gotta look like Rain Clean Clorox Bleach.
Don't be fooled by bargain bleaches. Only Rain Clean Clorox Bleach smells fresh as a spring rain.
Told ya.
Try Rain Clean Clorox Bleach.
Gobi's been with me for years now. I feed him Alpo because it's got real beef in it. I plan on having him around for a long time.
Now with 50% more beef, because a great dog deserves Alpo. From Friskies.
And you can tell everybody.
The music everyone loves.
This is the song that I sing.
By the biggest names in music.
Ooh, baby, I love you, there's a warm wind.
Introducing the one and only Love album.
And I'd really love to see you tonight. If you're wondering what this song.
24 classic love songs together on one incredible 2-CD collection.
I want to make it with you.
I'm not alone. I'm so lost without you.
I'm not alone. So don't forget it.
24 of the greatest soft rock hits ever.
Without you, my endless love.
All the big number one hits you love.
There was something in the air.
Nearly 2 hours of classic love songs on two cassettes or two CDs.
I'll stand by.
This is the ultimate love collection.
I'll stand by you. Someone like you.
The one and only album for you and your loved one.
Somebody else.
Every one of these classic love songs comes straight from the heart. Call now to order the one and only Love Album. Yours now for a special low price on cassette or CD. To order the one and only Love Album, call the number on your screen or send check or money order for $24.99 for CDs or $19.99 for cassettes to the address above. Rush delivery available. Call now.
Today's Martha Stewart Living is brought to you by Clorox Bleach and by Maytag. Closed captioning is made possible by the following sponsor.
How fast does Maximum Strength Ambisol start to relieve toothache and canker sore pain? Before you can say,
Ambisol.
Put it on, the pain is gone.
Luscious Nestle Sweet Success shakes. So rich, creamy, and decadent. With Nestle Sweet Success, you can lose it all and have it all at the same time.
We're going to enjoy the marrow and to savor every delectable bit. You can use what are known as marrow spoons or marrow scoops. These we borrowed from James Robinson, and they hearken from the 18th century in Europe or in England. I'm just releasing the string around our marrow bone and unfurling the leek leaves so that I can show you how, in the olden days, this most wonderful part of the bone was enjoyed with a scoop like this. The wider scoop, the wider portion, was used for these larger bones. And this long, skinny, elongated portion was for long, narrow bones. And what they did was just scoop out the marrow. You could just eat it with the end of the spoon like this. Very good. A little bit more salt and a little bit more pepper. Or you could just remove the entire portion of the marrow like that and enjoy it on a toast crouton. Marrow isn't to everyone's liking, but if you like pot-au-feu and you like marrow, a marrow spoon will make an easy job of extracting the marrow. Tool of the week, an 18th century marrow spoon. Thanks, James Robinson. You can find more interesting projects and ideas like those from today's show in our magazine, Martha Stewart Living. To subscribe, call our 800 number.